I'm a 52-year-old female. Should I continue to use Rogaine 5% foam for androgenetic alopecia after having PRP ACell? Is there a natural alternative to Rogaine to help with hair loss without side effects?
Thank you for your question. You've submitted a question without a photo, but you state in your question that you're a 52-year-old female and that you want to know whether or not to continue taking minoxidil or using minoxidil 5% after undergoing treatment with PRP and ACell. And so certainly I could understand that type of question, even though we don't have any further details about your clinical picture. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon, fellowship-trained oculofacial, plastic, and reconstructive surgeon. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, a system we developed for using ACell and PRP starting about 7 years ago, and we've developed protocols that are specific based on a very large volume of patients who we have been treating from all over the world for this past 7 years. And so I would suspect that in this situation, your clinical picture is one that most likely is female pattern hair loss or androgenetic alopecia, which is the most common. Essentially 95% of hair loss is genetic pattern hair loss, male or female pattern hair loss. I can tell you that over the past several years, especially in the early stages when we were first developing these protocols of PRP and ACell, which actually derived from treating patients who we were doing hair transplant for, and from hair transplant where we were trying to improve the yield of the grafts as well as the healing of the donor area, improvement of that area, we found that thinning hair became thicker. And in developing systems and processes for women, we definitely had to overcome a large special group of obstacles. We were dealing with issues with inflammation, we were dealing with issues of hair shedding. We were at times in the early years wondering whether or not we should even pursue treating female pattern hair loss. But as time went on, I made refinements into the system and the process and reduced to a minimum the amount of shedding that would occur as a consequence of the treatment. And ultimately, it has become a very effective treatment for female pattern hair loss. Generally speaking, with more than 5 years of cumulative data, and again, doing this for more than 7 years, and probably having the largest volume of patients, again, coming from all over the world, I would say that this has turned out to be a really good treatment for female pattern hair loss. We've been able to improve the density of hair, we've been able to improve the quality of the hair, and it has been quite successful. So the question about minoxidil and the role that it plays in terms of treatment of hair loss, well, basically it's a pharmaceutical which prolongs the growth cycles, and it's the only FDA-approved treatment at the current time for female pattern hair loss, topical minoxidil. Now, the challenge for us when patients come with this, let's say, longer than 6 months or a year of using minoxidil, the question of whether or not to stop the topical placement is sometimes a challenge, and we still have to individualize it. But in general, I would say that if you stop using minoxidil abruptly, then there's a good chance that there's going to be a significant degree of shedding that may appear to be more than it actually is, but certainly can be distressing and concerning. For those patients, I generally tell them to just stay on the minoxidil for a few months, and we try to eventually wean them off of it. But when we do a treatment like this PRP ACell we call hair regeneration, and that we and the company we started, TrichoStem Hair Regeneration, we do the treatment and expect that for some people there's going to be a certain amount of hair shedding, particularly if hairs that are close to the end of a growth cycle. Now that generally means that there may be some shedding that can be concerning, but it has been my experience that that shedding related to the treatment does not last more than a few months. However, people can have other reasons for shedding, so what I try to do is minimize the potential causes. So being on minoxidil, and if it's well tolerated, then I would keep the patient on minoxidil. And we follow our patients very closely. We have we are able to make these statements about 5 years of data plus, because we see our patients every 3 to 6 months, and we do that for the duration of 5 years after the treatment. So we're able to really have good data and get a lot of feedback about the experiences, and of course we are able to document their improvement. So I would say that discuss this with your doctor and learn about what their experience is doing this treatment. This is still a treatment which has a lot of people doing it in their own special way, and we're doing it in our way, and we again derived a lot of information probably having a lot of experience being in the front of the parade more than 7 years ago. But again, I feel like what we've developed is very individualized and based on a lot of specific data that applies based on age of onset, degree of hair loss, type of hair loss, as well, and these protocols have been refined and are always continuously being refined. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.